everything that anybody else said about it besides me to basically said this was the biggest nothing burger ever. I know you had Dean Baquet here from the New York Times yesterday, and they covered it like it was Pearl Harbor. Comey was more than happy to talk about my emails, but he wouldn't talk about investigation of the Russians.
What do we make of this? Besides the fact that the 2016 campaign apparently will never end, it hurts, and we can be snarky about this sometimes. Running for president is quite a personal ordeal for anyone who gets in the arena, and it hurts. And she thought up until the last hour she was going to win. However, what purpose does it serve to trash the DNC, and so on and so forth at this point?
Yeah, there was an interesting turn from her yesterday, because we've heard the rationale about Comey, and we've heard Russia. This was the first we've really heard from her blaming the party. In one sense, she is not wrong. Barack Obama, when he was president, really ran his own data operations. He kept things very close into his own political operation, and that hurt the DNC. That is true to some extent. She didn't inherit nothing from the DNC, and there's a lot of pushback that you're hearing privately from people who worked for the committee. I think the interesting thing with Clinton right now is that, yes, I think there is a desire that's perhaps more intense when it comes to her to see her take ownership. People want to see her be humble. I think that it is more intense when it comes to her. But if you are going to be out there, if you did just lose this election, you are going to be out there discussing it. That is the expectation. I don't know what she thinks that people will want to talk to her about at this point, other than what went wrong and led to this pretty unbelievable defeat on her half.
And there's the trying to have it both ways, saying, you know, I was flawed, it was my fault, but it was also all these other entities' fault. And it kind of dilutes any sort of the buck stops here statement that she has. And, you know, frankly, it seems like she's burning bridges within her own party at this point.
It's an issue of tone as well, in a way. I mean, there's a way of saying she kind of took the, you know, oh, well, I had problems, but the big problems were in the party. Whereas if she'd done it the opposite way, you know, to say, you know, there are still problems in the party that we should think about fixing and itemize them, which you can do,
no,
but the buck stops
you don't
here,
understand.
As you're saying.
You don't understand. The Russians cloaked Wisconsin, so she couldn't find it on a map to get there and campaign there.
And I think if you're a Democrat, I think a lot of them would prefer to have her fade away a little bit. I mean, a lot of them would say the reason they lost the last election, despite a very vulnerable Republican candidate, is that people turned on Hillary Clinton. Republicans were able to make her be a villain. And I think an advantage that Democrats have coming up is they don't have someone who's easy to villainize. They want to make the next couple of elections a referendum on Donald Trump. And the more their last standard bearer continues to be present, continues to speak out, I think they feel like that's not going to be good for them.
It's part of this. When Trump came up, one of the questions still for investigators is, yes, there's no doubt in the intelligence community. The